In this mini lecture, I'm going to talk to you about managing people in your teacher librarian role. As the teacher librarian, you're going to be managing up, managing down, and managing across. Managing up is managing a hierarchy above you, so senior management, executive, administration, the leadership of the school. Managing down includes managing the people who are lower than you in the hierarchy. This may include other teacher librarians if you're the head of library services in a very big school, but will most likely include support staff such as library technicians or school officers, your parent volunteers and other volunteers, and potentially students who are library monitors or hold similar roles. Managing across includes managing other teaching staff in the school. A very common definition of management is that it involves planning, organising, leading and controlling. So when you're addressing managing in your portfolio, you need to bear in mind these different aspects, and in this mini lecture, these will inform how I talk about management of people. Principles of school library management first. Although the teacher librarian is responsible for the school library, the library belongs to the whole school community. This means that the TL involves the school community in planning, organising, leading and controlling. You are the manager of the library, but the library exists for the school. We want to avoid all those terrible teacher librarian stereotypes of the teacher librarian being the dragon lady, the teacher librarian being the gatekeeper, etc. Those stereotypes have no place in contemporary best practice and for highly accomplished teacher librarianship. The whole point of the teacher librarian role and the school library is to improve learning in all of its dimensions: reading, literacy, information literacy, digital literacies, and so forth. So everything that you do in the role of the teacher librarian needs to be directed to this aim. Finally, it's usually best to take baby steps. Let's say you're appointed at a school and you go and change everything you need to in the first few months. Obviously, you'll want to put your stamp on the library, and you might spend a lot of time thinking about the million things that you want to do. But if you go about doing them all really quickly, without getting to know the school community and the way that the school operates, you might not only create animosity, you might also make the wrong decisions. It's really important to work carefully with the school community. Building relationships is the most important first step. Even though you might be burning to start culling or redesigning the library space, this is the library as the school community is familiar with it. And if you begin by making radical changes without having built up relationships, the community may not understand what you are doing or why. It's also difficult for you to make informed decisions about what the community needs and wants before you've spent some time working there. Although you may see what could be changed to align with best practice, it needs to be best practice within that particular context. You can't make those types of decisions accurately when you don't know the community and the school procedures. A good foundation is a strategic plan for your library, which speaks to the strategic plan of the school, and an operational plan, which shows how you are going to actually implement your strategic plan over time. So now we've addressed the first principles of managing people in the school library, let's talk specifically about managing up. In most schools, there's a hierarchy within the leadership. You'll almost definitely have a principal, but you might also have a deputy principal, heads of curriculum, heads of department, a business manager, etc. Here I'll speak about the principal, but in your context, this may be a head of campus or a deputy principal or someone holding some other leadership role. Your relationship with the principal or whoever you report to is extremely important. In most states of Australia, the role of the TL is not mandated. This means it is up to the principal usually to decide whether or not they want to direct funds to the role of the TL or whether they want to spend that money elsewhere. You need to be someone who the principal trusts and can go to when they have any information needs. To that end, it's good to find out what the principal's key performance indicators are, so you can help the principal achieve those. These will be related to the school strategic plan, which will also align with the plan for the library. Make sure you have formal and informal chats with your principal. Make appointments regularly to meet with the principal to keep him or her informed of what you're doing in the library and how this is contributing to the learning and the goals of the school. Keep your principal up to date with technology, pedagogy, or curriculum developments by sending them emails or putting new books and interesting articles on their desk. Use infographics to communicate data so they don't have to read through long chunks of text. An annual report is essential, and if you can present this in a visual and innovative way, they're more likely to read it and see what the library is doing to contribute to learning. It's also important to build an informal relationship with the principal so that they see you as someone who is working with them to forward the school in meeting its goals. This will mean that the principal is more likely to trust you, which is very important. After all, the library represents a significant investment of school funds, and if they're directing a lot of money towards the library and your role, they want to be sure that they have made the right decision. It's also important to set boundaries, what the library can and can't do, and what it's there for. Once again, you may find that having a positive relationship with the principal and school leadership will help you to ensure the library is respected and the library staff, including yourself, are not commandeered every time an extra set of hands is needed. This can happen if the principal and leadership don't understand the size and complexity of the TL role. You may recall in the management mini lecture that I referred to the iceberg model. If your principal only sees the tip of the iceberg and doesn't have an understanding of the large amount of invisible work that is happening under the surface, then you may find that the role and the space is undervalued and misused. So managing up is a very important part of the TL role. Setting the tone of the library environment is also a part of managing up. If the library has a vibrant, welcoming atmosphere, the principal will want to bring visitors to the school through the space, and the library will be a space which hosts lots of events, such as teacher-parent evenings, maybe school board meetings or PNC meetings. Having events in the library means that it's a space that is seen as a community hub and the principal will use and spend time in the library. It is vital that you can make an argument to the principal of the value of the TL role. You need to provide evidence to the principal and to other senior managers from the professional literature, the scholarly literature, and the data that you gather yourself. You also need to be able to express your strategic and operational plans to provide a basis for requests for resources that you need and to justify the decisions that you're going to make. It's also good to be informed of your industrial rights in terms of conditions and workload, and also staff-to-student ratios. If you haven't developed a good relationship with your principal and leadership team, addressing issues that you encounter is going to be far more challenging. On to managing down. This involves working with your support staff, your volunteers, and students who are working in the library. It's a great idea to organise training or professional development for your support staff. You will need to train volunteers and library monitors as well, and you need to manage expectations and define roles and responsibilities. This can be challenging if you've been appointed to a school that has a library aide or a library tech who has basically been running the library. They'll have particular ways of doing things and particular views on things, and they might be quite set in their ways. You need to be able to affirm that person's practice, but also be able to change that practice if needed and help them to see different ways of doing things. Your support staff can be your greatest ally, and it's a very difficult situation if you don't get on with your support staff or if you have different views about things, so getting them on board is a really high priority. Part of managing down is evaluating how you are working together to achieve the goals that are outlined in your strategic plans. There are various tools that you can use to do this. We've discussed the SWOT analysis in previous tutorials. This stands for strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, and threats. There are also other sorts of analyses called situational analysis and needs analysis, which are quite similar to SWOT and can even form part of your SWOT analysis. You need to evaluate everything that you do and that your staff are doing in the library. You also need to gather data to assess student learning, which is Standard 5 of the AITSL standards. Student learning data can include how library programs are improving student learning and how work you do with classroom teachers is influencing student achievement. Another thing that you need to do in terms of evaluating library services is to look at the benchmarking of your staffing levels, that is, the ratio of student enrolments to teacher librarians and support staff. The only data we have right now for benchmarking in this area are the soft link reports. Use the latest one in your portfolio. These reports also capture the size of the school library collections, so it's a really good idea to benchmark your collection to other libraries. An important thing to do when you're managing down, as well as managing up and across, is to celebrate the achievements of staff and students. The library can play a big part in celebrating all of the great achievements that happen across the school, and making the library available for celebrations makes it once again the hub of the community. Finally, let's look at managing across. One of the most important things the TL needs to do when managing across is setting boundaries. Again, because of that invisible part of the iceberg, teachers can have the misconception that the TL has more time and availability than a classroom teacher. Many of us have had experiences where suddenly a classroom teacher books the library and brings the class down to work on an assignment we have never seen before. It's really necessary to set boundaries and open channels of communication so that staff understand the appropriate way to interact with you and the library and how to use the library most effectively. For example, if you have a flexible timetable, then you can require that the class teacher comes to the library with their class and that you can plan units of work together so you can be sure that the collection has depth in the areas that the students are working in and you have time to prepare the appropriate pedagogies and resources. You can also suggest that you co-teach the units of work with teachers for greater student outcomes. If you're working within a fixed timetable, it may be that you're expected to cover non-contact release time for classroom teachers. This makes co-teaching and co-planning much more challenging. In these cases, you can still negotiate to be part of the unit planning, so that you not only get an insight into what curricular needs you need to cover within the collection, but also you can advise teachers on inquiry and research, on digital pedagogies, and provide them with the expertise you've gained through your teacher librarianship studies. Of course, not everyone will be open and willing to work with the TL from day one. One strategy is to work with those who are on your wavelength and who are interested in collaborating. Once others start to see the results you can achieve working in this way, they may come on board more willingly. There'll always be staff who you can't get on board and may not be supportive of what you want to do, and that's okay. Work with those you can, and as time passes and you build more relationships, things may change. Managing across also involves including the staff in writing and commenting on your library policies. You might share the draft of the policy at a staff meeting, or establish a smaller staff group that you bounce ideas off. When teachers are involved and understand the complexities of library policies, and particularly the collection management policy, they're more likely to start seeing that invisible part of your role and be more supportive of your endeavours. The worst thing you can do is write all of the library policies on your own and hand them over to staff as a fait accompli. This will not help you to build relationships or to educate the staff about your role and the role of the library. Managing people is all about being part of the school community. Spend time building your relationships with others, and managing up, down, and across will become a much less daunting challenge.